Am I recording? Okay, good, I am. Yes, okay, hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Andy here. So full disclosure, this company contacted me and sent me this guitar. And I said, they said, we like some of your reviews. Would you do a review on our guitar that we have in the Amazon shop right now? I said, yes, as long as I can be totally honest about it. They said, that's fine, and they sent me this. So they have sent me this. This is my guitar. This is the first guitar anybody has ever sent me. and I cherish it as such. Okay, we are opening the box. I'm going to be very careful. People always comment on how bad at opening boxes I am. Look how safe I'm being, everybody. See how my fingers are nice and far away from this? Well, okay. Anyway, this is kind of a weird box. It seemed like it was just a two-sided box. Then we have within it the secondary box packed very, very well. Again, look at my fingers. Nice and clear there, okay? And then within that, we have this nice cushy case. This is actually a good gig bag, this case for the guitar. It's not an actual case, obviously. We have the little added stuff there. The bag will open that very, very shortly. They also get rid of this black tablecloth. Okay, so we can see there we have some picks. We have the capo they gave me. They have the tuner. These are a set of extra strings. It was strung already. You'll see in a second. Here's the booklet they give you. The booklet is actually really useful. It has, safety precautions, though those aren't really, it's hard to be unsafe with an acoustic guitar, although be careful with those strings. It tells you about all the guitar parts. It'll give you big diagrams of all the different parts, and it'll tell you how to tune it, what the tuning theory is, how to replace strings, how to deal with the truss rod. It'll tell you all about the pickup setup they have, the piezo pickup in the body of the guitar. It'll describe all the control instructions, the battery placement, how to maintain the guitar. It's a really full little booklet, and I don't remember getting a lot of these with other guitars, okay? So, and they give you a strap, they give you a cord, they give you this nice microfiber chamois that I am using very often now, and you can see in the guitar they send, I've gotten guitars from people and they send like the case separate somehow. Luckily they sent it with, you can see they have the Allen wrench there. Okay, nothing in the gig bag, but you can see it's not like a super thick gig bag, but it's fine. It's like maybe an inch thick. It's pretty good. And then here is the guitar. Yes, I know I'm not being careful, but here we are. We can take off the paper off the strings, very delicately laid, and you can see that the color is the matte black that is advertised. It is not a great paint job, I will be brutally honest, right here at the top, but it is actually a pretty good looking guitar. It isn't a bad capo. It works. I've actually used it recently, so it's not a bad capo. It's a totally functional capo. Okay, we can see the paint job here. I've wiped it off pretty good. Any mark you see on here actually came with it. So this is the main drawback of the guitar, as we will discover here. It has these little white chips on there. You can see the paint job looks like there's been different, it dried at different temperatures, and there's moisture, and there's finger marks. I'm going to CC. That's not my finger mark. Those things have, it came with it, right? I'm going to wipe it off here with the microfiber thing, which you don't always get with guitars because most paint jobs don't collect. This is not a good paint, I don't think, personally, for a guitar. You can see the dust just doesn't want to come off there. You can see the there's little wobbles there and the color shift. Though it is largely straight, it is, again, like a really, it's a pretty well-made guitar. Everything feels solid on it. The binding feels good. It has pretty good action, not too high. I might lower it a little bit. And there's some unevenness in the paint job. But everything else about this guitar feels pretty good. It just, I don't know why they would have like a rush job of this color paint. So that's one of the larger kind of drawbacks of this guitar. But I think ultimately it looks pretty good. I like that little indent there. And I really like the inner binding and the outer binding on the look. I don't know why they felt the need to paint the neck. So there's issues with the paint job, okay? But that is not everything to a guitar. It's not like the paint is coming off in your hands or anything. You know, it's a finished paint job. It just wasn't totally up to what some of the other aspects of the guitar are. So I've been playing it a little bit. It's a really sturdy feeling guitar. And actually, the other day, I accidentally let this thing drop off of, you can see I have too many guitars for the space I have here. And I had this guitar on my swivel chair, and the swivel kind of moved out, and the guitar fell right on the headstock. and the neck is still straight. And it's a really well put together guitar, actually. It isn't cheaply made. I could really see this being kind of an easy gigging guitar, or just bring it outside and you don't necessarily have to worry about it in the same way you would with other guitars. Really like the binding, really like the inner binding, which is just even just a subtle bit of color there on the inside. The neck is painted. It looks like they maybe just did one coat of paint on it because some of the wood is coming through. I really like, actually, the bottom of the neck here with this kind of indent into the guitar. They send you the pick guard, which I stuck on myself. You can choose to put it on or not. I chose to. Simple headstock. Logo is applied clean there. Tuning machines are actually really pretty good. I don't know if this is going to be the case on everybody's guitar, but for this guitar, it stays in tune, generally. I mean, they're cheaper tuning machines, I'm sure, but they actually look really nice and they feel pretty smooth. It doesn't feel like there's a lot of kind of loose spots in there. The other big thing I will say is it has a really nice, crisp, open tone. You really hear those mid-tones opening up. It's really broad. I will say, also, it was intonated out of the box, okay? So I don't know if that's going to be the case with every other guitar, if they just intonated it for me. So like in terms of like a really cheap acoustic guitar, sometimes they can really have that plasticky sound. Sometimes even not so cheap acoustic guitars can sound kind of thin. You don't want a guitar that's going to sound kind of too metallic or brassy. And I think this actually really has a nice tone. Bright, you know, it's a bright tone, but I hear all those mid-tones. Now, obviously, we have the different levels here so that we can switch. So let's see, if I blast the bass, how does that sound? Mids, you can get. Right, we can hear. We want to blast that treble. We can get that really nice sound there. It's not a bad sounding guitar. I can't really find huge faults with the sound. It has a really nice, crisp, open sound. I want to play this guitar. I want to play songs on this guitar. It has a cutaway up here, just in case you want to get, you know, you want to get nuts and start doing electric stuff on the Let me not get carried away here. This is a guitar that is actually been near me for the last couple days as I've been sick and just wanting to tool around on something. It's been great to have it just there, and if you're banging into something, it's not that big of a deal, right? So we have our input here. I never understood, and I love Tellys, and I love a lot of guitars. For whatever reason, we put the thing here when it's way better in here. I always think, put it in the strap button. That's what I always say. I never understand why you want it here, because it just gets in the way and you're just forever going to have bumping against your knee or your leg or whatever. Okay. Yes, I know sometimes people play standing up, but with an acoustic guitar, you really want the jack coming out of the button there. We also have totally unfinished frets. The action is also pretty good on this guitar. Like, you can move pretty quickly on it. The problem is that the frets are unfinished and they are pretty sharp, okay? So be careful. I mean, they don't really periscope out over the neck, but you can cut yourself on these. I would definitely take this to be set up by somebody or somebody who knows how to file down frets, because it's just going to slow you down. When a company is going to throw a bunch of things at you that are in the deal, right? They're going to give you a strap, they're going to give you strings, they're going to give you a tuner, they're going to give you a capo. It's not a great capo, but it works, you know? So if you're if you like to play with capos, it's a perfectly serviceable capo, perfectly serviceable tuning machine. They give you, or they gave me batteries for both. A general standard rule that if people are going to send you a whole bunch of extras with something, it's because they're worried about the quality of the instrument itself. Now, usually what I guess is that these are going to be purchased by people who are doing like a big kit starter pack. Maybe you have a guitar player in your life, maybe you have a young guitar player in your life, and you want them to kind of have the whole package going forward. In general, I would recommend against a deal like this for somebody like that. I would get them a guitar that you know is going to last a really long time, that they're really going to love the look of, and that they're going to really appreciate over the course of years. You can get a really good acoustic guitar for $200 in a lot of different places, okay? So that said, this is not a terrible guitar. And if you have been given this guitar, if you have just started playing this guitar, I'm not disappointed in this guitar at all, okay? Again, the only big thing for me is the paint job. So yes, there are drawbacks to this guitar. There's drawbacks to purchasing even just a deal like this in general. But I think in general, it is a really, really good deal. I understand why these are tough to beat, because this is a solid guitar. It's a fun guitar to play. Sounds good. Takes a licking, keeps on ticking, right? It fell over and like the neck stayed perfectly straight. I didn't need to adjust the truss rod, stayed intonated. With all those caveats and any political positions people might have about labor costs aside, and those are perfectly valid. People can have all the political positions you want about labor costs, et cetera. Putting that aside, though, I think this is a terrific deal. So now I'm just going to play a little bit, and you can hear some different tones at different parts of the neck. It's a really snappy kind of feel on it. Not playing anymore. Thank you. There's also a little bit of buzz. Again, if you take it in to get set up, there may be a few dead spots on the neck. The frets are really rough, so if you start playing it, your hands may get tired really quickly. Just have them attend to those things. Make sure the neck is nice and pristine before you take it home. Okie doke. So hopefully, let me know if you've got this guitar, if you're planning on getting this car, what your thoughts are in the comments. Do you like it? Do you not like it? Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? Was it set up? Was it intonated for you? Did you get the same type of guitar that I did? I'd be very, very curious. It has a snappy low end. Like, it has a fun little low end. Like, it's a good, cheap, pretty well-made guitar. I think you probably got a good deal on it. Hopefully you like yours. And until next time, keep playing.